a concept. Today we'll find out what you are and how to use you to solve those pesky math questions. Let's take a look at this question. Thor and Hulk punched each other multiple times in a contest of champions battle. 3/4 of Thor's punches were equal to 2/3 of Hulk's punches. Both of them punched a total of 408 times. How many times did Thor punch the Hulk? So here we have a classic example of a question that uses the equal concept. Okay, we often see this concept being tested whenever we have information that compares two fractions, okay, of different items that represents the same amount. Okay, so let me show you guys what I mean. In this case, the two fractions that are being compared, okay, are actually 3/4 over here and 2/3 over here. Okay, then can you find the two different items that are being compared? If you said Thor's punches and Hulk's punches, you're right. And how do you know they represent the same amount? Okay, here, we know that because of the keyword equal. Okay, so if we were to express this sentence, 3/4 of Thor's punches were equal to 2/3 of Hulk's punches in a mathematical form, it will look something like this. Okay? Okay, it's important to note that when we are talking about the equal concept, sometimes these comparisons can be done in the form of percentages, okay, or decimals also. So instead of 3/4 and 2/3, we can say something like 20% of Thor's punches equals to, let's say, 60% of Hulk's punches. Or, in the case of decimals, we can say 0.5 of the nuggets, okay, is equal to 0.8 of perhaps hot dogs. Okay, so whenever you're given something, like how much of item 1 is equal to how much of item 2, you know that the question is secretly trying to test if you know how to use the equal concept. Alright? Food for thought. What if you see something like this? 50% of the fish balls is equal to 1/4 of cuttlefish balls. Will you use the equal concept too? Type your answers in the comment section below and let us know what you think. So back to the question. What happens if we see a question that involves the equal concept? Okay, how do we go about solving this? Well, it looks like our heroes today have some answers for us. Wow, looks like the Hulk is suggesting to use the model method. Let's take a look at how to draw the model for this question. 3/4 of Thor's punches were equal to 2/3 of Hulk's punches. So what does this actually mean? Okay, this means that out of the 4 units that Thor has, 3 of them actually represents the same amount as 2 units of Hulk. Okay, so when we draw the model, we'll have something like this. And don't forget that this amount here is being compared to 2/3, meaning that this is 2 units out of the 3 units, okay, that Hulk has. And what else do we know? Okay, we know that both of them punch a total of 408 times. Wow. Okay, so let's label it here. So our model is done. Or is it? Okay, looking at this model, we realize something very weird. Okay, because the 3 units here are supposed to be equal to the 2 units here. But do they look the same to you? No, right? So what we need to do next is to make all the units the same. Do you know how to do that? We can do that by using the lowest common multiple, okay, between 3 here and 2 here. And what is the lowest common multiple between 3 and 2? Okay, it'll be 6. So the next thing we need to do is to ask ourselves, how do we make the 3 units here to 6 units? Okay, we do that by dividing each original unit into 2. So here we go, we divide one big unit of Thor, okay, into 2 smaller units, and we do the same to every single unit that Thor has. Now that we're done with Thor, let's look at Hulk's units. How do we make these 2 huge units into 6 pieces? You realize that by comparing, all you need to do is to divide one big unit into three pieces. So we do the same for the rest of them. So you realize that now we have made the number of units that Thor has and Hulk has, okay, for this portion, the same. Alright? Now that all the units are equal, what can we tell from the model itself? Simply by looking at the model, we should be able to see that 17 units here would represent 408 punches. Correct? So, how do we make use of this to find the number of times that Thor punched the Hulk? So, all we need to do is to find what is the value of one unit. Okay, and we can do that by taking 408 divided by 17, which gives us a value of 24 punches. And now that we know one unit represents 24 punches, finding the value of 8 units should be easy peasy, okay? All we need to do is to take, okay, 24 times 8, and this would give us a value of 192 punches. Question solved. Do you really think so? Let's take a look. So looks like Thor's method involves making the numerator the same. What's this? Is this really faster? So 3/4 of Thor's punches equals to 2/3 of Hulk's. Okay, we know that already. So in order to make the numerator the same, I guess we have to find the lowest common multiple between 3 and 2 again. Okay, and we have found out that this is 6. So let's look at 3/4 first. In order to turn 3 into 6, we multiply it by 2 on the top. Okay, and we also multiply it by 2 at the bottom. Okay, then looking at Hulk's side, 2/3, in order to make 2 into 6, we have to multiply it by 3 on top. Okay, and don't forget we have to do the same below also. Okay, so 3 times 3. Great. Now we have this 6 over 8 of Thor's punches equals to 6 over 9 of Hulk's punches. Looks like we have successfully made the numerators of these two fractions the same. Pro tip, to check if you have done the conversion correctly, all you need to do is to simply reduce the fraction here to the simplest form, and we should be able to get back the original fractions that we were working with. Alright? So, at this point, I'm sure that all of us will be wondering, why are we making the numerator the same anyway? How does this help us? Let's take a look at the model that Hulk drew previously. Wow! Do you realize that making the numerator of both fractions the same is actually a shortcut to drawing the model? Not bad, Thor. Not bad. Do you see what I see? Are we seeing the same things? Let's take a closer look to see what each number of the fractions mean. First of all, we realize that the numerators on top, 6, actually represents this part, the number of units that are equal in Hulk's model, correct? Now, can you guess what this 8 and 9 here means? Ah, I see. Do you see it? If we observe closely, we realize that this 8 here actually represents the total number of units that Thor has. And I'm sure you clever people out there would have figured out that this 9 here, okay, would represent the total number of units that Hulk has. So looks like instead of going through the trouble of drawing the model, if we were to make the numerators of the fraction the same, okay, we would be able to get the same kind of information. And this is especially useful when we're dealing with bigger numbers. Alright, so let's see how we continue from what we have, okay? So now that we know what each number represents, the next few steps to solve the question will be the same as Hulk's, okay? So we know that the total number of punches is 408, okay? We know that the total number of units would be 8 units plus 9 units, which gives us 17 units. Okay, so if 17 units gives us 408 punches, we would be able to solve for 1 unit. Okay, so in order to find the number of times that Thor punched, Okay, all we need to do is to find the value of 8 units, and we can do that by taking 24 multiplied by 8. Okay, and this will give us a value of 192. Done. Equal concept showdown. Which method do you prefer? Let us know in the comment section below. Game to try similar math question and win prizes? Join us today at practicle.sg. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more of such videos, do give us a thumbs up below and subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye!